As we all know, India has a rich diversity of fish genetic resources. There are about 30,000 species of fish globally, and we have over 2,500 species. So it's roughly about 10% of the global aquatic biodiversity. Due to various natural and anthropogenic stresses, many species have become endangered and threatened. Therefore, knowing the chromosomal number and type, also called karyotype, is the very first step towards genetic characterization. The information on diploid number is the basic prerequisite for chromosome manipulation and ploidy induction. Well, there are more potent markers nowadays, but then several leading geneticists started their initial work on fish cytogenetics, then switched over to molecular cytogenetics, and then population genetics, molecular markers, and so on and so forth.
A karyotype is the number and appearance of chromosomes in the nucleus of a eukaryotic cell. The term is also used for complete set of chromosomes in a species or an individual organism. Karyotype describes the chromosome count of an organism and what these chromosomes look like under a light microscope. Attention is paid to their length, the position of centromeres, banding pattern, any differences between the sex chromosomes, and any other physical characteristics. The preparation and study of karyotypes is part of cytogenetics. The study of whole sets of chromosomes is also sometimes known as karyology. The chromosomes are depicted in a standard format that is known as a karyogram or a ideogram.
First of all, we'll collect a healthy fish and inject with 0.05% colchicine intramuscularly at a rate of 1 ml per 100 gram of body weight. And after injection, let a fish swim for 1 to 2 hours.
After 2 hours, the fish is anesthetized with a solution of 50 parts per million ethylene glycol at the rate of 20 grams per liter. The kidney and gill tissues are removed by dissection, cut into small pieces and homogenized in a hypotonic solution of 0.56% of potassium chloride.
So now, here we get the cell suspension. The cells were treated with hypotonic solution so that the cell swells and rupture the cell membrane easily. Now we'll give it for 30 minutes for cell swelling.
Stop the hypotonic action by adding 1 to 2 milliliters freshly prepared chilled carnoise fixative gradually. Centrifuge the sample for 10 minutes at 1200 to 1500 RPM. Now we will take a small quantity of the cell suspension and drop it onto a pre-warmed slide from 2 feet height.
This is the photograph of the spread. Now we'll cut the individual chromosomes and group it according to the categories.
For karyotyping, the chromosomes need to be classified based on their morphology. The most common method of classification is based on their arm ratio. They are classified as metacentric, submetacentric, subtelocentric, and telocentric. In addition to conventional GIMSA staining technique, there are different chromosome bending techniques. Chromosome bending is a technique by which serial bands are induced along the length of chromosome. It helps to study the chromosomal morphology in detail. G-bending is a popular technique that involves digestion of chromosome with trypsin followed by GIMSA staining. This gives a series of lightly and darkly stained bands. The dark regions are heterochromatic and AT rich, while the light regions are euchromatic and GC rich. Nucleolar organizer regions are the secondary constructions on the chromosomes that can be observed as black spots on chromosome by using silver nitrate staining technique. Q-banding involves staining with quinacrine mustard to produce fluorescent serial bands. Fluorescence in situ hybridization is a molecular cytogenetic technique that uses fluorescent probes that bind to only those part of chromosome with a high degree of sequence complementarity, which enables to detect and localize the presence and absence of specific DNA sequences on chromosomes.
Cytogenetic markers have been used as a tool for species hybridization, screening of hybrids, and detection of specific stock and population of fish species. Due to higher polymorphism of molecular markers and possibilities of high throughput analysis, the focus has been shifted to microsatellite and SNPs. The modern day techniques of fluorescent in situ hybridization utilizes this very method for preparing chromosome spread that can be probed with a fluorescent labeled DNA sequence to determine a locus of choice.